Good morning, everybody. This is Sean Copeland. Today is Saturday, October the 28th, and welcome to another brand new life-changing edition of the Kingdom-Driven CEO. Today on the Kingdom-Driven CEO, we are going to talk about green pastures. And this is pretty easy for me to talk about today because in about 2 hours, well, about three, but 3 hours, I am headed to the World Series with my son. We're going to head down to Arlington. Finn and I are with two really good friends of ours, and we are going to watch the Rangers and the Diamondbacks. We're praying for the Rangers to win. No offense, Diamondbacks, but it's time for our Rangers. So I'm so excited. I can't wait. And I think this devotional is super important today in light of everything that is going on in our world. So let me read this to you, and then I want to just kind of give you some thoughts. Lie down in green pastures of peace. Learn to unwind whenever possible, resting in the presence of your shepherd. This electronic age keeps my children wired much of the time, too tense to find me in the midst of their moments. I built into your very being the need for rest. How twisted the world has become when people feel guilty about meeting this basic need. How much time and energy they waste by being always on the go rather than taking time to seek my direction for their lives. I have called you to walk with me down paths of peace. I want you to blaze a trail for others who desire to live in my peaceful presence. I have chosen you less for your strengths than for your weaknesses, which amplify your need for me. Depend on me more and more, and I will shower peace on all your paths. He makes me lie down in green pastures. Psalm 23 is one of my very, very favorites. So I want you to think about this for a moment, and I want to point out one part of this devotional that is so important. It says, I want you to blaze a trail for others who desire to live in my peaceful presence. During this time, it is critical that the followers of Jesus live in peace, practice peace, and show others how to live in peace. And I want you to think about this very carefully with me. The Lord showed me this morning. When everything is good and everybody is fine and nobody is concerned about anything in their lives, it's very difficult to draw people to God because they don't need anything. They feel self-sufficient. When things are difficult and people become scared, all of a sudden, those with peace are going to stand out, and everybody's going to want peace, so they are going to gravitate to you, and you can share why you have peace. But you have to have it first. You can't fake it. People can tell. So I want you to think about sheep. Now, I grew up on a farm. We did not raise sheep. We raise cattle, but it's very, very similar. One of my best friends did raise sheep, so I know a lot about them. Let me tell you what I know about sheep and the reason that I think people are always compared to sheep in the Bible by Jesus. Here's why he compares us. One, sheep have a herd mentality. They tend to follow the front, the leader. And wherever the leader goes, even if it's off a cliff, there they go as well. They are not particularly bright, no offense to us as a species, but I think we are proving at the current time that we could certainly stand a little bit more intelligence. And then finally, they are very fragile. They're vulnerable to predators. We'll talk more about that in just a moment. But we know that sheep can benefit from the care and tenderness of the great shepherd. They are protected by their shepherd. Now, interestingly, sheep will not lie down and rest while something is bothering them, okay? If they are hungry, if they have fleas, if they have ticks, if they have other pests, if they have conflict with another lamb, if they are scared, they will not lie down. Now, some sheep don't want help. Okay, they lack trust, they're independent, they run away, they want to do things on their own. The shepherd could help them, but he can't because they won't allow it. So God is telling us, like the sheep, lie down in the green pasture. Don't just pass through, enjoy the moment, enjoy life, and rest. Life does not have to be as hard as we make it. And rest, God even practiced rest. In Genesis 2, 2 and 3, he said by the seventh day, God had finished the work he had been doing. So on the seventh day, he rested from all his work. And God blessed the seventh day and made it holy because on it, he rested from all the work of creating that he had done. Now, this morning, I was praying over this message to you today, and I believe the Lord showed me that another really, really big reason why we need to enjoy the good times, rest in the good times, is it prepares us to go through the challenges, the valleys, the desert ahead. Okay? It's important that we rest while we can. We went on a trip last weekend to Nashville. I actually visited with you from there. We did a tour with my daughter at a college there, and it was super fun. And I made a decision on Saturday while we were there to just leave my phone in the room. So we spent all day together. I didn't even have my phone with me. It was weird. It was a little bit of a detox moment, but it was amazing to live fully without being distracted by these phones. And we've seen this through our discipleship group, The Journey. We go on a retreat. I think we're going in early December. And for 2 hours, we will spend time with God, just praising Him, praying, talking with Him. And it also is life-changing for everybody that does it, and we can all do that. God rested on the seventh day. Now, I love the mornings, as you know, and I used to get up really, really early at 4, but what I noticed was I was having trouble getting to bed any earlier than 10, so I was only getting 6 and maybe even 5 hours of sleep per night. And I began to notice that without getting enough rest, I could not remember anything. I was getting very, very forgetful, very tired in the afternoon. We have to rest. I had to move my wake-up time back by about an hour to begin to get rest since I was going to bed at around 10. This devotional, and the reason that I wanted to share it today with you, is because it came at the perfect time for me, and I want to share a story with you. I'm a fixer. I tend to grind on a problem until I can figure it out, but we're dealing with a challenge in the banking industry that is really not solvable right now. The interest rates have gone up so fast that our funding cost has gone up much faster than our lending cost. So in a typical business setting, our inventory cost has shot up and our sales price has not. So what has happened is our margin, everybody's margin, is beginning to narrow. About a fourth of the banks in the country are losing money today. We are not. Thankfully, we are in good shape, but we're certainly not doing as well as we have in the past. So I just think about solving this problem all the time. So I get up a couple of days ago, and I'm reading this devotional, and I'm praying, and I forgot to turn off my notifications. So right in the middle of my prayer and reading this devotional about lying down in green pastures, I received this text from my brother, Richard Piles. "Brother, God put you on my heart this morning to remind you that God has it. I don't know why, but he didn't let me leave my house until I texted you. Have the best day, brother. Now I can leave. I love you so much." Richard had no idea what was going on in my life. He had no idea what I was dealing with that day, but he is abiding. He's listening to the Holy Spirit, and God told him to reach out to me, and God is so good. Luke 1:79 says, "To shine on those living in darkness and in the shadow of death to guide our feet into the path of peace. God wants us to have peace. Now, I want to take a look at just the first couple of verses in Psalm 23, and then we'll just wrap up here with a couple of quick thoughts. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. So let's think about this for just a moment. Let's take a shepherd's look at Psalm 23. A good shepherd can fix all of the sheep's issues, okay? He can protect the sheep. He can separate them from each other when they are frustrated and fighting. He feeds them. He delouses them and gets rid of all the pests. The sheep rest better when the shepherd is there. So should we. We just need to acknowledge his presence. He will work for us. He will work out our conflicts. He will protect us. He will provide for us if we will just listen to him and trust in him and not be like the independent sheep that runs to the backside of the pasture. When I was in the Secretary of Commerce role, I would often look at the week ahead, and we were doing, you know, all kinds of COVID-related programs, recruitment. I had a whole bunch of agencies, and many times it literally did not seem possible. But the shepherd led me each and every day, and it was. Unfortunately, some people, like sheep, don't want help. They lack trust. They're independent. They run away and want to do it on their own. And let's not be like that. Let's love him, thank him, praise him all day long. Let's accept the peace that surpasses all understanding that comes from the shepherd with us. And I want to give you one final thought that the Lord just shared with me. We must trust and follow the good shepherd to get to the wonderful lush pastures, okay? We cannot get there on our own. We don't know where they are, but he will guide us. But when we are there, we must rest. The shepherd knows his pastures, okay? He moves us along. They would typically graze in a circular motion. So they knew that this is the best grass right here. This is where you got to rest. Then we might go into some tougher territory and it's going to be more difficult. But he knows and he moves us along as he sees fit. Okay? So God may be moving you right now into a new pasture. You may be feeling unsettled. You may be feeling like it's time for a change, and you need to pray for that because that may be God's way of moving you into the new pasture. So today, let's rest in God's love. Let's have comfort that the shepherd will take care of us day by day, and let's show peace that is very attractive to others. We will stand out today. I have had more people comment on my optimism and positive nature in the last week than I have in the last 5 years combined, and it's because they are down, and when you are not, they want to know why you are different. Let's tell them and point them to Jesus Christ. So let me close this out in prayer today, and thank you so much for joining us on today's Kingdom Driven CEO. Dear Heavenly Father, I know it is a tumultuous time, whether you're in Maine or you're in Mexico or you're in Ukraine or you're in Israel or you're in Gaza. Wherever, you know, you are right now, there is something going on that can pull us away from peace. But Father, I pray today that we would all remember you are the good shepherd. There are predators out there. There are predators that want to come after us, but you will protect us if we will just trust in you. Help us to take this truth into our world, to have a peaceful countenance, a positive countenance, and that it will draw other people to us and we will point them to you. Help us to be a light unto our worlds today. In Jesus' name, amen. And I want to thank you so much for joining this edition of the Kingdom Driven CEO. We'll see you next Saturday morning.
colors of blue.